Hello, welcome to ISTQB Foundation Level Syllabus, and today we are going to see the third review technique, that is a scenario and dry run based review technique. So let's start with our topic. So first we will talk about the reviewer. Here the reviewer will have a guideline, and based on that particular guideline, reviewer will perform his review on the work product which he will get. So in the ad hoc based testing, in the review technique, we didn't have any guidelines itself, whereas in checklist based review technique, we had a checklist, and depending upon that, reviewer was checking the work product. And now here the reviewer will have a guideline, and based on that particular guideline, reviewer will perform his review. Let's see that what is the process he is going to follow. So the reviewer will perform dry run on the work products based on the expected usage of the product. So first he has to understand that how this product will be used, and depending upon that, what he will be doing is a dry run. So that when he is performing a dry run, people will ask question. They will ask question only if they have a knowledge about that product. For example, if this is a requirement which we have already seen, for a web page, when the login detail is given, the next page shall load within few milliseconds, and if login detail are not correct, then show a pop-up. So in this particular document, if the user knows that how this particular web pages work, when how the login thing works, when the login is not happening, what type of information is coming for different sites. So if he has that particular basic idea about it, then only by when a reviewer is going through all these lines, then the people will get this particular question and they will ask. Otherwise, if they have no idea, then they cannot ask all these questions, like how much time it will take, because it is written few milliseconds. And here it is written is which page will load next, because here they have told next page will be loaded. So if you have a basic idea how the web page works, when you click the next page comes, there will be some information. So based on that particular idea only, you can ask the question. So that is the reason here during the preparation stage, it is very important that the reviewer try to understand the usage of the product. So once he knows how that particular product is used, or how the web page work in this particular scenario, then only he can be able to formulate more questions, and he can ask all the questions and find the defects based on the scenario. So that is why the preparation is very much important in a scenario based review technique. Now what the success factor? The success factor will totally depend upon the understanding of the product. So if you have a better understanding how the web page works, then you can develop more questions, and you can ask more questions during your meeting, and you can close all the points, and you will develop a very good product out of it. So here the reviewer will have a guideline. The process is they will just go through the requirement, but they will be prepared for that particular work product. Like they will know that how that product will be working. So the preparation stage is understanding the product well, and the success factor will totally depend how good you have understood about the product. So that is it all about the scenario based testing. I will see you in my next video. Until then, happy testing.